Good afternoon. We start with breaking news coming out of Queensland, where police have just given an update on the deadly police shooting at Wieambilla in the Western Downs last December, which took the lives of two police officers and a neighbour. Queensland police, along with counter-terrorism police and the FBI, have arrested a 58-year-old man in the United States on Friday.
One of those threats made relates to comments posted online in December 2022, inciting violence in connection with the incident at Wieambilla. The man repeatedly sent messages containing Christian end of days ideology to Gareth and then later to Stacey.
We will bring you more on this story coming up shortly with our reporter. Well, a terrifying night for residents at an aged care home in Sydney's south after a projectile was fired through a window as residents slept. Worried staff raised the alarm. Police arrived then to find a ball bearing among shattered glass at Estia Health in Bexley. Officers are appealing for public information.
It appears to be a completely random, reckless and unacceptable act.
That's rather reckless behaviour because you don't know what's on the other side of the glass.
Thankfully, though, no one was injured. Well, tempers have flared within federal parliament as a rush to new laws through parliament to lock up some former immigration detainees. Joining us now is federal politics reporter Eliza Redwoods. Eliza, good afternoon. How soon will we see this legislation passed?
Well, soon, Davina. The government wants this done tonight. The legislation will be introduced into the lower house in coming hours after passing the Senate. The feeling is there is a sense of urgency here after three released immigration detainees were arrested for various reoffending. The most serious was an indecent assault charge and a convicted child sex offender who was charged with contacting a minor. They were part of a cohort of almost 150 immigration detainees who were released after a High Court ruling. These new laws going through Parliament will allow the government to apply to have them re-detained, but it'll be up to a judge to make that final decision. This morning, ministers were reluctant to say how many applications they'd be putting forward. The press conference became pretty fiery when the Attorney General was asked whether Australians deserve an apology over the criminal offences allegedly committed by those released into the community.
I will not be apologising for upholding the law. I will not be apologising for pursuing the rule of law, and I will not be apologising for acting. Do not interrupt. I will not be apologising for acting. I will not be apologising for acting in accordance with a High Court decision. Your question is an absurd one.
Eliza, National Cabinet met this morning. What's been agreed to?
Well, Davina, a few areas of agreement out of today's meeting. The federal government will extend for another 3 years what's called the No Worse Off Guarantee. That was set to expire in 2027, and that ensures GST payments to the states will continue being topped up. While the states have agreed to chip in more funding for the National Disability Insurance Scheme to deal with soaring costs.
At the moment, NDIS funding is agreed by everyone, including the review, to be unsustainable. What we want to do, though, is to make sure that the principles in which the NDIS was established, that those people who need that support continue to get it.
Davina, leaders also agreed to establish a national firearms registry. That'll be up and running within 4 years.
OK. Eliza, thank you. Well, the Prime Minister has remembered fellow politician Peta Murphy as a happy warrior who spent her life fighting for the rights of others. The 50-year-old federal MP from Victoria died this week, 4 years after her breast cancer returned.
A fiercely loyal friend and colleague, a boss her staff adored, and a brilliant, funny, courageous and caring person who made this a better parliament.
As a parliamentarian contending with cancer, Peta bore burdens of the mind and pains of the body that most of us will never fathom. Yet how remarkable, despite all that she was going through and the pressures of public office, that she so rarely dropped her sunny disposition or was devoid of a smile.
Flowers were left on the MP's seat in Parliament, many colleagues reflecting on the colour she added to their lives. Well, there are big changes coming to our mail. Australia Post today announcing they'll modernise to keep up with online shopping demand. Letter delivery services will be reduced to every second day, while parcel and priority mail services will be delivered every day.
These reforms will continue to allow us to serve our customers, both in the growing parcel business, as well as to maintain the essential mail services we have, particularly priority mail and express mail, which will still be delivered every single day.
The federal government and CEO assuring that the changes will not lead to the closure of post offices. We'll have more on that story coming up in 30 minutes. Those who can afford it are keen to help others who are struggling at this time of year. But even goodwill is being targeted by scammers. And here to discuss that is Sue Woodward from the National Charity Regulator. Sue, welcome. What forms do these fake charity scams take, and just how bad is this problem?
Thanks, Davina. It is really sad to think that when people are being asked to donate to charities that there are scammers out there. They are very clever, they have a variety of forms, and the main message really is just to be very vigilant about not clicking on links and social media posts and so forth, but rather relying on checking that that charity is a real charity, and people can do that with the charity register that we host.
How much money do you think roughly we lose to these fake charities?
It's a bit frightening, really. The official figures from the Scam Centre show that in last year alone it was about $3.1 billion.
Wow.
That's a big figure. That could be going to, you know, help a lot of, you know, grassroots organisations do their important work. And we know that this is actually an underestimate of the figure, because a lot of people don't bother to report if they've been scammed or embarrassed to report. So it is an underestimation, but that figure alone is really frightening.
As Commissioner, what's your view of these people, given that the need for so many Australians right now is so great?
It is. It's really the lowest of the low, isn't it? When you think of charities really trying to do their best, particularly for people in the upcoming, you know, summer season, the festive season, it's the time when charities are working and we're all on summer holidays. We really need people to be donating and supporting the great work that these charities do. And yet the thought that you give your hard-earned money to a charity to help others and that's been taken by a scammer is really distressing.
So how do you make sure your money is going to the right place?
The best thing you can do is don't click on those links. Don't just give your bank details over the phone. Just stop and pause. You can look on your mobile phone. You just type in charity register, you'll find our register, you can look up the name of the charity. Just make sure it's got that authentication of being a registered charity. If you want to know more about the organisation, you can check the details of what they say they do, where they operate, the money they get, the people that run them, organisation. But even checking that they're on the register is such a simple, quick thing to do.
And that's just as simple as putting charity register into our search engines online.
It is, actually. You can literally Google charity register and it will come up. You can also put in Australian Charities Commission. You go to our website and there's a very big button that says search a charity, and you can put in the details and go from there.
Well, thank you so much, Sue, for everything you're doing. Let's hope it makes a difference.
No, thank you to you and all the charities out there doing their amazing work. Thank you.